As explained in my previous video, a website is just a folder with a bunch of files in it. Almost every website out there can be viewed from anywhere in the world. In order for this to be possible, a website should be stored on a computer that's always on, has enough power to handle multiple connections simultaneously, and has the necessary software to automatically serve websites to the users. A computer that matches with the above criteria is called a web server. Web servers usually do not have any peripherals, since after the first configuration, they do all the work automatically. There are a lot of websites on the internet, and in order for your computer to find them, they are given specific addresses called IP addresses. Just as any address in real life describing the geographical location of a particular building, IP address describes a website's location in the World Wide Web. But unlike real life ones, it looks a bit different. It looks like four sets of numbers divided by a dot. You can perfectly connect to a website by typing its address in the address bar of your browser. But that's not really convenient, since humans are really bad at memorizing random numbers. That's why smart computer scientists decided to also give names to the websites. They are called domain names. Google.com, NASA.gov, Wikipedia.org are examples of domain names. But here's the tricky part. Domain name by itself can't tell your browser the location of the website. And again, smart computer scientists found a solution for this. They created a system that binds IP addresses and domain names together and called it DNS. So every time you type some website's domain name in your browser, it connects to a DNS server, requests the website's IP address, and uses it to reach the server the website is stored on. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, hit that like button below and subscribe to stay tuned for the upcoming videos.